My sincere greetings to everyone. Today we are going to discuss a very beautiful poem which is written by Alfred Lord Tennyson, and the title of the poem is Crossing the Bar. Before starting with the explanation of the poem, let me tell you something about the poet. Alfred Tennyson is considered the most representative voice of the Victorian England. The fourth of 12 children, he was the son of George Tennyson. Tennyson was partly educated at Louth Grammar School and partly at Trinity College, Cambridge, where he won the Chancellor's Gold Medal for poetry. At a very early age, he showed a calling to poetry, and in 1827, with his brother Charles, he published a book titled Poems by Two Brothers, which was followed by his first independent volume of poems, that is, Poems Chiefly Lyrical, in 1830. He was appointed Poet Laureate of England after the death of Wordsworth in 1850. His poetry gave comfort and solace to a large number of people who were troubled by evil, cruelty, and widespread poverty that resulted from the industrial society of the 19th century. Tennyson is perhaps unexcelled for his variety of themes, unparalleled sense of beauty, and delicacy of workmanship. His simplicity of diction never fails in dignity. Sometimes it develops into a magical verbal felicity. His excellence lies not only in any depth of passion, but in perfection of form, which contributes to the enjoyment of his poetry. Tennyson, thus, in his abilities and limitations, his moral concerns and didactic purpose, his engagement with legend and history on one hand, and his spirit of inquiry and scientific progress on the other hand, represents the contradictions of the Victorian age. This was all about Lord Tennyson. Students, he was really a very great poet. Now let me tell you something about this particular poem which is prescribed in your syllabus, that is Crossing the Bar. Crossing the Bar is one of the most famous and intensely moving poem from a poet nearing the end of his life. Tennyson wrote this poem at the age of 81. Even Tennyson was not oblivious to the crowning glory of the poem. Stressing the significance of this lyric, his son Hallam adds, "A few days before my father's death, he said to me, 'Mind you put Crossing the Bar at the end of my poems.' This was done accordingly." This poem contains four quatrains, and it is a symbol of Tennyson's mind and art. It celebrates the poet's confession of his faith in that divine and unseen who is always guiding us. After a long struggle with doubt, he restored to himself and his deeply disturbed society the much needed faith in God. The poem is an allegory of spiritual journey. Through the metaphor of the voyage of a ship across the ocean, the poet anticipates his death and tells of the philosophies, the eternal truth, that we come from the eternal past, and after a brief stay on the earth, we pass to the eternal future. On the surface, it describes the poet's voyage on the sea, but really, it is the description of the soul's journey from this world to the next world, which is its eternal home. The poet believes that human soul is immortal. Death is merely the end of the body. The soul does not die. It is immortal. Death is merely the journey of the soul from this world to the other. The poet is not at all afraid of death. He feels no agitation at its approach. He is very sure that his soul would live on and would ultimately become one with the divine. Tennyson looks upon God as his pilot, just as an expert pilot who knows the channels leading out to the sea, across the sandbar, steers the ship clear and safe. God also guides the human soul through life and through death. The poem thus ends with a note of optimism and expresses Tennyson's faith in God and the immortality of the human soul. Now let's talk about the structure and the form of this poem. This poem is written in stanzas of 4 lines each. The first rhyming with the third and the second line rhyming with the fourth line. The poem belongs to the category of a perfect lyric. The images of the sea, originating from the traditional symbols and metaphors, dominate this lyric. If the first 2 stanzas recreate the music of the sea, the last 2 resonate with the music of the evening bell. Both the thought and the music of the poem are equally admirable. Now let me read this beautiful poem for all of you. Crossing the bar, sunset and evening star, and one clear call for me, and may there be no moaning of the bar when I put out to sea. But such a tide as moving seems asleep, too full for sound and form, when that which drew from out the boundless deep turns again home. Twilight and evening bell, and after that the dark, and may there be no sadness of farewell when I embark. For though from out are born of time and place, the flood may bear me far, I hope to see my pilot face to face when I have crossed the bar. No doubt, the poem belongs to the category of a perfect lyric. Let me explain the first 4 lines of the poem. Sunset and evening star, and one clear call for me, and may there be no moaning of the bar when I put out to sea. Moaning means deep, sad sound, that is weeping and crying. The other meanings are quite simple. Bar here means sandbar or sandbank. Put out to sea means move out to sea from a harbor. In the above 4 lines, it is very clear that the sun is setting and the evening star has appeared. The poet is old and he hears the clear call of death. His only wish is that there should be no moaning and crying when he dies. The sunset and evening star symbolize old age or the evening of the life. The clear call is the call of death. The poet hears it in his old age. He knows that his death is approaching. Tennyson actually died 3 years after the poem was written. The poet wishes that the weather should be calm and quiet. He wishes that there should be no moaning, no crying, no weeping, and the wailing of the sea waves means he wants to die calmly and quietly. He does not want any mourning on the part of his friends. The sandbar is here a symbol of death, and the harbor is a symbol of man's short stay on this earth. Putting out to sea symbolizes the beginning of soul's journey for heaven after the physical death of a person. When the poet dies, his soul will sail for the other world. The journey of the soul from this world to the other world has been compared to the sailing out of a ship. Now, the next 4 lines. But such a tide as moving seems asleep, too full for sound and form, when that which drew from out the boundless deep turns again home. In these lines, the poet wishes that when he puts out to sea, the weather should be perfectly calm and quiet. The waves should move gently. They should be as calm and quiet as a sleeping person. In other words, the poet does not want any disturbance when his soul sails for the next world. He wants the sea to be deep and full. It will be then easy for the ship to cross the bar. When the sea is deep and full, there is no sound and no form. It is calm and quiet. Then there is no risk or danger to the ship while it is crossing the sandbar. In other words, the poet wants to die calmly without any pain. He also wants that his soul's journey to the next world should be very smooth. The soul is here compared to the ship. The ocean is the ocean of eternity, which separates this life from life in the other world. Home refers to the other world. it is the real home of the soul. It is from here that the soul comes to this world for a short stay and to where it returns after death. The next four lines, twilight and evening bell, and after that the dark, and may there be no sadness of farewell when I embark. Twilight means evening, and evening bell is an indication that the day, that is the time of stay on this earth, has ended. The dark means the darkness of death. Embark means to set sail for the other world after death. The poet is already old. It is the evening of his life. He is already hearing the call of death. Soon, the darkness of death would fall upon him. He wishes that when he dies and his soul sets sail for the other world, there should be no crying and no wailing. Twilight and evening bell indicate that it is evening and the activity of the day must end. They are a symbol of old age and the close of life. Just as evening is followed by the darkness of night, so old age is also followed by the darkness of death. The poet wants that his friends should bid him a cheerful farewell. They should not cry. He does not want any expression of grief over his death. Now let us start the last four lines of this poem. For though from out are born of time and place, the flood may bear me far, I hope to see my pilot face to face when I've crossed the bar. Born means boundary. Born of time and place means this world, which is limited by considerations of time and place, and there are no such limitations in heaven. The flood means the tide of death. Pilot here means God. Cross the bar means cross the ocean of eternity after death. Let me explain these lines. The poet is not at all afraid of death. Rather, he welcomes it. He hopes to see God face to face after his death. This world is limited in considerations of time and space. There are no such limitations in the other world, that is heaven. It is infinite both in time and space. Death will take the poet out of the bounds of time and space. His soul will then sail across the ocean of eternity. After crossing this ocean, it will reach the other world, which is its real home. And when he has crossed the ocean of eternity and reached the other world, he will be able to see the pilot, that is, the God there. The poet means to say that it is God who will guide his soul to heaven after his death. And then in heaven, he will be able to see his pilot, his God, face to face. Let me try to explain this poem in Hindi as well. इस पोयम में जो पोइट है वो बहुत बूढ़ा हो गया है और उसको पता है कि उसकी डेथ कभी भी हो सकती है और उसकी केवल एक ही इच्छा है कि जब वो मरे तो कोई रोए धोए नहीं, कोई बहुत ज़्यादा तमाशा ना हो। और इस पोयम में जो एक इवनिंग का बार बार जिक्र हुआ है, ट्वेलाइट का जिक्र हुआ है, वो एक तरह से सिम्बॉलिक है ओल्ड एज का। क्लियर कॉल का मतलब है कि डेथ का जो है वो बुलावा आ गया है और पोइट को पता है कि वो अब जो है मरने वाला है। और टेनिसन की जो डेथ है वो इस पोयम के 3 साल बाद ही, जब उसने लिखी थी ये पोयम, तो हो गई थी। और पोइट एक ही चीज़ चाहता है कि जब वो मरे तो समुद्र का जो मौसम है वो शांत हो। ये पोयम मल्टीपल एक मीनिंग्स लिए हुए है। पहला तो ये है कि पोइट दिखा रहा है कि वो जो है एक अपना ओशन को, एक समुद्र को क्रॉस कर रहा है, राइट? और वो जो ओशन है, समुद्र है, वो किसका सिंबल है? एक ओशन ऑफ एटर्निटी का। वो धरती से लेके हेवन तक का सफ़र तय करना चाहता है। उसकी जो आत्मा है वो धरती से लेके भगवान तक चली जाएगी आफ्टर हिज डेथ। और जो पोइट है वो बिल्कुल भी डरता नहीं है, बल्कि वो डेथ का स्वागत करता है, उसका वेलकम करता है, क्योंकि उसको लगता है कि वो अपनी डेथ के बाद अपने भगवान को, अपने पायलट को सामने देख पाएगा। एक छोटा सा डायग्राम है जिसको देख के आपको पोयम एक मिनट में समझ में आ जाएगी। लेट मी एक्सप्लेन दैट डायग्राम टू यू। हमारी जो जर्नी है, जो हमारा शिप है, जो इंसान का एक सिंबॉलिक है, जो इंसान है वो अपनी जर्नी स्टार्ट करता है ओशन पे शिप के रूप में, और वो शिप जो है वो सैंड बार को क्रॉस करके दूसरी दुनिया में चला जाएगा। जो सैंड बार है वो सिंबॉलिक है डेथ का, और द पोइट वॉन्ट्स कि जब वो मरे तो समुद्र में कोई हलचल ना हो, जो वेव्स हैं वो सारे शांत रहें। शांत रहें का मतलब पोइट जो है जब वो मर जाए तो लोग उसके डेथ पे ज़रा सा भी रोए नहीं, समुद्र में कोई हलचल ना हो। तो बेटा दिस पोएम इज़ वेरी वेरी सिंपल। द पोएम रिफ्लेक्ट्स द पोइट्स जर्नी फ्रॉम दिस वर्ल्ड टू द अदर वर्ल्ड। ये जो पोएम है, इस पोएम को पढ़ने के बाद हमें पता लगता है कि टेनिसन जो है वो भगवान में बहुत ज़्यादा विश्वास रखते थे, और वो जो है अपने विक्टोरियन एज के एक ऐसे पोइट रहे हैं जो कि लोगों की जो आस्था है उस टाइम ख़त्म हो गई थी भगवान को लेके। तो इस पोएम और इनकी बाकी पोएम्स को पढ़ने के बाद लोगों में वो फेथ फिर से जागृत हो गया था। आई होप कि अब ये पोएम आपको अच्छे से समझ में आ गई होगी। एंड लेट अस वेट फॉर द अदर वीडियो फॉर द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स रिलेटेड टू दिस पोएम। थैंक यू एंड हैव अ नाइस डे।